This is a very interesting table about independence. We take here in the middle, you have the word Atzmaut, the independence. Also, you have a good meeting, best meeting is Yom Atzmaut, but definitely we are looking at it from Torah point of view. And the most amazing thing is that it comes in the minimal skip, which is 70 letters in between. You can see it here, 70, and only in few, two chapters in Genesis. You can see all of Genesis 23 up to the beginning of 24. Amazingly, in a short area, you have all these things about Hebron. You have Hebron here. You can see Hebron, Eretz Nan, land of Canaan, which is the name for Israel, but as Chida says, the reason for it is because Canaan in Hebrew means surrendering, subduing, and it shows that only in the merit of subduing, surrendering to God, believing in Hashem, to being humble, and realizing that everything is from Hashem, and that we got to learn from Hashem, not with our force. And even we got it, it is only the help of heaven, these miracles. We know quite well in the Six Day War, that only miracles brought Israel to get back Yerushalayim and Hebron. And here you have also, amazingly, all this story comes with the story when Abraham bought Me'arat HaMachpelah, here is Me'arat HaMachpelah in Hebron, and here is written clearly that it became his possession. You see, and the reason why the Torah went into such lengths to tell us that Abraham bought the place with money, so the Midrash says, because the Torah knew that in future will come people like Ishmael, the Arabs, and even Europe, and claim, no, it is not yours, you should not build in heaven, give it back, like the European said last days. So, no doubt, the Torah comes and tells us that it is not like this, it is ours, it is our possession, and here again, Neva Machpelah. And what is interesting, you have also the day comes with Eretz Moled, the land of our birth. This is all our history started from here. Now, Hashem Elokei Shamayim Va'aretz, God is the God of heaven and earth. No doubt that without believing in the Torah, like unfortunately the leftists and all this, what we have today, unfortunately, those who don't believe in the Torah, so automatically they have lots of problems. Hebron, yeah. And also, as we saw in another YouTube table, that Hebron, also the word Hebron comes Chibur Nun, connecting to the Nun, very mystical idea of the deep connection between Hebron to the highest verse. And we say that according to Kabbalah, Hebron is the brain of the Israel and the brain of the world, Jerusalem is the heart. So no doubt that this is why such opposition to Hebron, like we saw, as we said, European, you aren't allowed to build, is not yours. And the Arabs definitely, now this is the conflict of today, really deep, not political problems, much more spiritual. And what we see here coming also always, tshuva, repentance, only repentance, getting back to our sources, believing in Hashem, in the Torah, only this will give us the land with no problem, Hebron. And as we see clearly, that the real independence is depending on the spiritual things, not on physical, not on army, not on all other things they try to show in the day of independence, but it is only believing in Hashem and to do the Israelis Eretz Kanaan. It is really a land that we have to realize that it is the hand of God, He gave us to us, and only then we'll really have Eretz Moledes, that our land will be completely ours, no problems as we have today, unfortunately. Even Israel himself will claim you are conquerors, it is not yours, give it back to the Arabs and so on. How could these are people who are lacking knowledge in Torah and believing in Torah, cutting themselves from the proper tradition? So let us really hope that learning and studying properly our history, the book of Genesis,